Erfjan in Kuwait. This is where I've been sleeping. Actually quite nice. Open bays, as you can see. It's really rough in here. Got running water. Bunk beds, very comfortable. Not exactly the rough life. So Ken, want to say hello to everyone?
What's happening?
What are you reading? Oh, a book.
Yeah.
The Fly Boys. See ya.
Later.
So you can see we traveled 6,000 miles, and here we are, everyone gathered around, really roughing it here in Kuwait, watching television. Can you believe this? Can you believe this? Don't interrupt. Sit around.
It's so small, but...
Pardon me. Hey, it's not the size that counts. Say hello, everybody.
Hey, hello, everybody. Okay.
We're watching a lot of Flechamina.
This is a family tape. Where we're going to be playing tonight for our first show in Camp Erfjan, Kuwait. This is going to be the smallest venue of the trip, from what I'm told. And I saw Rich here this afternoon. I'll be seeing him later on tonight. This is where he's stationed. It's incredible luck. As you can see, I found Rich, or I should say he found me.
I'm here.
Any message you want to say to anyone at home?
I love you all.
He's lying. He doesn't love everyone.
Have a good Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Hey, Amon.
So,
when are you coming home now? You're coming home in March?
Or yeah, March. End of March.
Okay, so everything is fine. No cars have been wrecked.
Not yet.
You still got that Bahamian tan?
I'm good.
Okay. So Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Yeah, that's more like it. Okay. Farewell from Camp Erfjan in the beautiful country of Kuwait. City to Baghdad today. This is our accommodation. Hello there. How are you?
Good.
That's the girl from Jack, Carrie. This is our lovely seating. It's like a pretty darn comfortable. Right? Lots of leg room. Lots of it.
All right. Here's our major.
Baghdad International Airport. Friday, December 19th, at 8 o'clock in the morning, local time. bird. Big dog.
Probably a 203 around that went high, because you can see there's other ones probably trying to get somebody in the doors.
Wow.
Notice that fragrance in the air. The smell you smelled in Kuwait was burning off of petroleum. Okay. The smell you smell here is burning the garbage. Okay. By burning the garbage, they eventually hope to get to a sound EPA level of only so many tons of garbage and trash per cubic.
Wow. Is that much?
Oh, you'll see it, yeah.
Is there a head over there?
Yes, there is.
Hello, Ken McGee.
Wave hello. That's Ken. That's about as much as you're going to get out of Ken today. Here are the Blackhawks that the celebrities are going to be traveling in today. They're going to be flying to remote areas. And they're bringing our Army Band vocalists with them to Mosul, to Crete, and to... Oh boy, I can't remember the other place. Colonel Lamb is going to Crete with Crystal and Colin, or Caleb. Sorry. We just landed here at the airport less than an hour ago. They're already getting ready to trans. It's pretty exciting. It's a beautiful day today. Clear sky. Temperature is wonderful. About 70. Perfect weather. Blackhawk helicopter. Blackhawks all over the place. You can see. Here's where the concert's going to be tomorrow. Better shots of that later on. It's a gigantic hangar. What you're about to see is quite impressive. This is to prove that I'm really here. This is for real. So here we go. This is where we're actually staying tonight. Let's go inside and see my house for the next 2 days. This is no joke.
Thank you.
This is the real deal, my friends.
I'm gonna get my Lebanese friend back on the
channel. Yeah, that's a great idea. You know what? That's a good idea. Ahmed Mohammed, you guys take a look at this. I don't know if you can see it. The lighting is terrible. Maybe I'll get a different shot of this later. I'll give just a little time on that. If you can translate that, that would be just fantastic. And here's another one. You can freeze frame that and take a look at it if you want to. Anyway, the fact is, this is one of Saddam's palaces that obviously has been liberated by coalition forces. Get a load of this place. Just get a load of this. Just soak it in. Look at this place. It's obscene. Here's this more inscription on the wall. If you fellas can translate that, I'd be forever in your debt. This is just the downstairs, obviously. Here's the Jed Clampett-like staircase. It's two of those. Ah, there we go. Thank you. Look at this place. Marble. Everything is marble. Isn't that something? Beautiful. I'm sorry, this is so shaky. I'm carrying my Kevlar helmet on this same arm. It's a little heavy. I apologize for the bad camera workmanship here. You see a little throne here. I've got to get a picture of that. Me sitting on that baby. Who knows how many people sat on that thing? Isn't that strange? Here's more inscription on this that maybe the fellas can look at. Just give you a second on that, guys. Okay. Pretty swanky chair, huh? Now, of course, here is Pièce de Résistance. Get a load of this. Look at that. That is a chandelier.
Hey Frank.
Look at that. Isn't that just the most beautiful thing? Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
I can't get over it. Look at that thing. See the work on the edges here. The trim's beautiful. Just beautiful. And then back off here. See what on top of it, you can't see it too well. There you go. Look at that. It's insane. Beautiful work. Huh. Look at that. Isn't that something? Of our digs for the day.
We can play hide and go seek in here later.
Well, it probably has five zip codes.
Just
to fix this building. We're taking a look at that. One of Saddam's bathrooms here.
Right next.
Oh.
Yep. Been bidets.
I don't know what to say.
The evil one got his ass washed in the interview. Holy shit.
Isn't that something? The bidet. Lights don't work. There's a couple of things that are funny about this place. The bathroom's only semi-functional. But they aren't quite attractive. Look at that. Can you believe that? Hello. Ah. This is outrageous. Outrageous, man.
Yeah, I know. I gotta get a photo of the bathroom.
Of course.
Yeah, no question.
Guys, what does this mean?
You got somebody who can translate back home?
Yeah, I have two nephews who speak, my sister actually speaks Arabic.
Wow. I got a good buddy. It's alright, man. I got a good buddy who speaks Arabic.
Oh, yeah?
He grew up in Lebanon for the 15
months. Maybe you can send him this stuff.
Yeah, I'm sure he can read all this stuff.
Oh, that's not gonna work. Okay, does this, Okay. So we're just gonna go upstairs and see where we're staying. I just can't believe this place. Actually, take a little stroll over here. See these doors? Pretty wood doors. You can take a look at all the marble flooring. They didn't scrimp. That's for sure. A pretty couch here. You know all the junk on the walls? I think there's been a lot of pictures been ripped down off the walls in this place for obvious reasons. There's no hot water and there's only two toilets that work, which is very strange. However, it is a sight for sore eyes. It's a strikingly beautiful place. Doesn't look that old either. We drove up, it looks like it was almost in the middle of construction. The chandelier just cracks me up. Here's another nice one. And that's some. Another shot of that chandelier. Where we're staying, I think it must have been a bar or some sort. As you can see, it's a makeshift dorm for us.
Going co-ed tonight, do you?
Oh, but we're not gonna mind.
Do what?
Sergeant Trees is over there on the other side by herself.
You see here is probably get some better shots this way. There's a man-made lake. This is ridiculous. This guy had some money. He stole that, no doubt.
We've got quite a few other beaches.
You're not subscribed. I can walk around my store.
Please don't. Hey Scott, would you give us a brief dialogue about what it was like this morning and what our living accommodations are here for the troops back home?
We discovered a good many things about our comrades here, many of whom probably sleep in separate rooms from their spouses, given the volume at which they snore. Other than that, we're very comfortable. Our backs feel great. These cots have these wonderful lumbar supports that I've never quite experienced.
How about the water situation here in the palace?
Well, you know, you wouldn't think that a cold water trickle would be enough to shave, but as long as you can bear the pain, it's wonderful.
Thank you, Ken. That's on tape for your family and friends. Remember, we're in a palace. Just to let you guys know the irony of it all, this is a palace. And we're lucky, this thing they call lights, we're lucky to have. So,
As long as Danny Roberts doesn't plug anything else in, we'll have those lights.
Yeah, thanks a lot. He blew the fuses out this morning before. Wait.
I'm going to forget seeing that cute Australian chick with the machine gun. I'm not going to forget that.
I'm not going to forget it.
That was cute. That's fucking beautiful.
One, two, three.
He didn't know what an O2 echo was. Yeah. That's a trombone player.
Six, seven,
can he do
all
ten?
The way down.
Can he do 10? Nine, can he do 10?
10 and one for the third major.
All
right. See the arc of that takeoff there. Look at that.
Holy sh!
I have never seen. I have never ever seen a commercial jet do that before.
Look at that arc.
You know, someone's blowing chunks on that plane right now.
Look at that arc, folks. Not from Kuwait.
Not from Kuwait, but we may be doing that when we leave.
Oh my gosh, look at that. That is incredible, man. Wow, that's going to stall out.
Yeah. Starts joking when the Sergeant Major brought around those cookies, you know. Yeah.
It's spiraling up.
Just a whole layout, man. This guy knew how to live.
There's a lot of fish out there too.
Yeah, I saw him jumping last night.
Look at that.
Salami Singh's wet bar. Look at Scott.
Amazing.
Yeah, I guys just bought this one too. And stepping in Jersey.
That's all right.
I'm gonna have to get another one next time we go to the PA.
Did you need to wash your hands, Luke? I got some antiseptic in the cleaner stuff.
Wow, look how deep that pool goes.
Gee
whiz.
No, this stuff I bought.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Thanks, man. Look at the damage. Wow, man. Jeez. Man, look at that. I'm tearing it all down here. The great palace of the great man. Look at that damage. This is called Iraqi air conditioning.
Careful, man. Careful. There's nothing there.
There's the Iraqi Baghdad International Airport.
From the third floor of some house, no less.
Yes. This kind of how to live or what? Look at this. It's from the third floor of the palace. Incredible. Formerly Saddam Hussein International Airport, now obviously Baghdad International Airport, or called BIOP, or BIOP, by the military folks here. You can see the runways are completely in line with the palace, which is very strange. So, just something weird. You can see smoke off in the distance here. You can only conjecture what that is. Can't be good. Although, I've been told that in order to meet certain environmental requirements here, by the coalition, the Iraqis have to burn off their trash. So they're burning trash at a phenomenal rate because the amount of trash they had built up since the war is beyond the limits of what the coalition wants. So they're actually burning the trash to meet standards, which is kind of ironic considering the stink it's putting in the air.
Ten Brigade.
Want to wave home to Frank? Want to wave home?
Hi, Mom! Here at the palace.
Here at the palace with all the dancers.
We're up on the roof having some mint juleps.
Living in the master's house, finally. Big construction site here. And of course, more smoke.
Yeah, I finally made it to the big house, Mom.
Oh, my God.
I'm now the HNC. Oh, this
HNIC.
HNIC.
HNIC, what's that?
Okay, yeah, I'd probably be waiting for me to say that damn word. It's the head Negro in charge.
Oh, I never heard that before.
The Uncle Tom.
Yeah. Look at the damage on that bridge.
Where we started.
All right.
Get down.
Wait, there's a ladder down here.
But I don't think that only puts us down here. Well, we can do that. We can walk over to the other ladder.
Black Hawk helicopter taking off. Seen traffic all day long here on the roof. Total access. Oh, we're going to get in big trouble. Or someone's got it zeroed in on their sniper rifle. We deserve it if we had it anyway. This is stupid being up here. But it can't help it. Look at that. Come on!
I thought you found one.
I got a liner, an extra liner.
There's at least three soldiers up there that don't have a bag.
Well, tonight we need to make sure everybody.
Just pull really hard. Just pull.
Push the button.
Push the button.
There you go.
There you go.
You need to make sure everybody split this shit up. I hope nobody take my sleeping bag, or I just left it in there.
One of the girls lost this, so they just gave her a sleeping bag rather than hang around.
So Aaron, where'd you guys go?
Went to Mosul.
And what time did he get back this morning?
11 o'clock.
And how did you get there?
Apache, it took 2 hours to get there.
In an Apache?
Yes. Really? Not Apache, Black Hawk.
You already said you can't find an Apache. That's a two-man helicopter.
Nah.
He was hanging on the.
No, but they were escorts though. Apache
like
was
Jackie
escort.
Fucking Chan.
A Black Hawk. Yeah, Apache escort.
Took Larry, 2 hours to get there. Larry, how fast were you guys going, and how high up in the air were you guys?
140 knots and about 125 feet.
And how long was the travel time?
The way out there was an hour. The way back, 30 minutes.
And where'd you go?
Junction City.
Y'all up, sir?
Just good, ready to rock. North of Baghdad, about 140 miles north of Baghdad.
You need to get your move.
Home of the 82nd. And also the Big Red One.
The Big Red One, that's right.
Red One,
one of the gentlemen with the Southern accent.
Well, welcome back, man.
But I won't tell the truth.
Right. You didn't know that?
What the fuck are you doing?
Oh, yeah. That was the first thing when I heard that he was on the trip. I went.
I know a lot of people like that.
What? Armed
convoy.
I was. That's what I'm telling them. I said he hates George Bush, and I'm surprised.
I know.
Well, you know,
he's a staunch Democrat.
Well, we're not. You realize it's not about.
We're not George Bush.
Guys that are over here.
I think
we're in it, and that's what it is.
I think that's exactly what.
Everybody should know the sword made to the army, right? No, I don't want to wink who I'm going to loud who. Every time I say something, I'm going to be real loud. Everybody should know the sword made to the army. I see these seven soldiers walking down to an airfield, an airfield airport, swinging those little bags. So I figured they knew who I was. So I walked up to him and I said, "Hey, how you doing?" He says, "Hey, how you doing?" I said, "Pretty good, how you doing?" He said, "Pretty good, how you doing?" I said, "Do you have that book that shows the Army rank structure?" He said, "Yup, sure do." I said, "Can I see it?" He said, "Yup, you sure can." So I put the book up, looked at the book, I said, "See this rank right here?" He said, "Yup, I sure do. It's a rank for PSC." He said, "Yup, it sure is." I said, "See this rank right here?" He said, "Yup." "That's rank for the Sergeant Major Army, isn't it?" He said, "Yup, it sure is." And I said, "That's me." He said, "No shit."
All right, it's a lot.
What about, First Army Division?
That's what I like to hear.
I know. Who is that? Third ACO? Second ACO?
Second ACO in the house. That's all right. I told you, Harriet. Call me Lance.
this is Jackox, and it's all business here.
Is it? Then why are you wearing that negligee? If you were madly in love with Lieutenant Lance Hartgrove, you would.
I am married on the show to Lieutenant Bud Roberts. I have two kids.
Yeah. Okay. Let's pick it up where we left off.
Lance, I'm wearing this negligee because tonight I want it to be very special. I want to give myself to you completely. Now, kiss me.
But, actually, you know,
do that because I love you, and because I love you, I would like to cut a deal with you. This is a one-time-only deal. Take a drink, okay?
Okay.
Okay. I show you the weapons, and in return, I get to go back to power and continue killing and torturing my people. What do you say? One time.
What do you guys say?
Okay, wait a minute. How about this? You uncuff me, and in exchange, you give me a 20-minute head start. That's all I need.
You know, I don't think
30 minutes head start.
I don't think I'm the one you should be negotiating with. I really don't. I don't have the authority, first of all.
But you're a lieutenant from Jack. You know, I love that show. Oh, I love it.
Thank you.
You know, I was wondering if you'll have the show's videotapes from last season and the beginning of this season. I've been in a hole.
No, I can't help you with that. Sorry.
Okay, well, forget the weapons, forget the tapes. I'm back in Baghdad. Oh, yes, I love it here.
Now that you're back, so tell us, what is one thing that you're really looking forward to doing?
Well, I guess two things, really. One, being further deloused. They missed some, mainly in the pubes. And Carrie, I don't have to tell you what that's like. Oh, no, I kid because I love. I love, that's why I kid, that's why Saddam kids. Saddam is a kid. But the other thing, more importantly than that, is I look forward to being reunited with my sons, Uday and Uze, my beloved boys. I didn't like the way you said it, but...
Well, you haven't heard the news?
What? They're in trouble again? Don't tell me. It's Uday. That Uday!
Let's just put it this way, Saddam. All of us here, and I think I can speak for all of us, really, really can't wait and would be thrilled when you are able to be reunited with your two sons.
Thank you. You know, if I had my AK-47, I'd be shooting it straight into the air right now. Thank you very much.
Saddam Hussein, everybody.
The Washington Redskins cheerleaders, and I was wondering if you could honor the guys and gals here with a little number. You're not allowed to dance? You're not even allowed to listen to music? Well, you know, we liberated Afghanistan. And actually, you're here in Baghdad. I don't see. What do you say, guys? You want to hear him? See him do a number? Huh? Okay. Will you do it? Well, hold on. I mean, anybody who was here in Afghanistan? Yeah. Well, you created their right to dance, didn't you? You'll do it? And you're gonna do it.
Thank you.
the liberals go and we can get back to business. Actually, I want to tell you, I disagree with Al Franken on everything political as far as across the spectrum, but what a great guy for coming to business, you guys. He has done that, I admire him for that. He just thinks wrong. I'd like to introduce a special friend of mine. She works for Fox News. She's the beauty with the brain. She looks gorgeous when you listen to her. She's also a genius. My sweetheart, Miss Meredith Whitney. I told Meredith she took me to Key West for my birthday, so I thought I should return the favor. I took her to Iraq for Christmas. I would like to, if I start slurring my words, I've been drinking beer with Stone Cold. I was going to drink all day, that's why I'm here. We threw out all the beer the rest of you guys. But I would like to say the reason I'm here is because I'm behind you guys. We go, you guys go to Afghanistan to war, I'm behind you. You guys go to Iraq, I'm behind you there. You guys go to a whorehouse in Amsterdam, I'm damn sure behind you there. Actually, I have no idea why I'm here. I love Sergeant Major Tilly, Daryl Warney, Mark Wills, and all the guys. But I'm not pretty like Miss Meredith. I don't have a brain. I don't have a body like these cheerleaders. I can't sing like Daryl Warley or Mark Wills. The only thing I actually do well is drink cold beer, and this son of a bitch is dry. So I'd like to ask you a favor. Next time you gotta drag some jackass out of a hole because he thinks he fucked the United States of America, can you do it? A country that serves cold beer. They said that when Euro Disney closed and the fireworks went off, three platoons of French soldiers surrendered. Not that I hate them. Okay, I hate them. You know, the last year I was in Afghanistan, Sean Penn was here in Baghdad under Hussein. Maybe we can invite him back now and put him in the same hole with that other son of a bitch. Saddam Hussein, we're trying to get him to talk now. I got an opinion on that. Find me a guy from Texas. Yeah! Texas? Then you guys know. Find me a guy named Joe Dan or Billy Bob. They're there somewhere. All of y'all know them. Put them in the room with Hussein. Tell them they can go home the minute he starts talking. You'll see something out of deliverance take place. Since 9/11, there hasn't been a major terror attack on our country. The reason is because you guys have done an unbelievable job. You know, they said it was about technology. It's not about technology. You give Al-Qaeda rocks, you give us sticks. Hell, you give them our technology, we take theirs, and I promise you, we still kick their ass. The reason is the American soldier. They said that we would run when blood was spilling. We ran. We ran right over their towel wearing ass. You guys have done an unbelievable job, and America loves you for that. You know, we reap the rewards of your sacrifice. You guys got to come home safe and understand and reap those same rewards yourself, because it's not fair that you're over here and making everybody safe at home. It's a wonderful country that you guys are defending. I told some guys last year when I was over here at Christmas and again when I was over here in July, I said, listen, if you ever see me at home, wherever I am, stop me and I'll buy you a beer. That has been a costly damn statement. I had no idea you guys drank that damn much. Soldier beer. I love every minute of it. You guys come home. guys. I wish you could only Merry Christmas, and I'm glad you guys are over here because you're making our country safe. God bless you. I love you. Thanks.
Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. And thank you so much for what you do and what you will do. You're the best. So I'll tell you what we're going to do. Is we're going to bring all the entertainers back up. Let's bring them all back up.
I'm telling you, man.
Swing around this way.
Yeah, you're right. That's a good idea.
I'm 6'3".
Okay. Oh my gosh. You're right.
So you got something to teach you to scale. I'm 6'3".
Thank you very much. Oh my gosh. Is everybody enjoying their breakfast in the Palace Conference Room?
Can you pass the salt?
Hey man, where's the hot sauce?
Is this part of the new band building look, Colonel?
I need
is this what you got
sauce.
For? This is great. I'll stand too, is at this marble table. Morning, Daryl.
Nice.
Gentlemen, Swah, how you doing, pal? Welcome back to the world.
Actually, I'm Gerardo.
Hey, Mark.
How you doing, sir?
Are you comfortable, Frank?
Absolutely.
Please don't get up on anyone's account.
I'm not, don't worry about it, man.
Oh, by the way, yeah, too sad. This is Frank Hart at work. This is the most work he's done the whole trip.
Yeah, man. Working so hard, I need a Gatorade.
Here's another hardworking soldier.
It was free in there.
It's bag PT.
What? Yeah.
Hey, no feet. Get your feet off the couch, man. And when you get done there, wipe your foot marks off.
Take off.
Scott.
Try not to.
Afghanistan. Take a look at this lack of sunlight. They consider this to be 5:45 in the afternoon because they run on Zulu time, which is 5 hours ahead of Eastern Standard Time, even though it's clearly not 5:45. Very strange. This is a strange place.
Afraid, no, I won't.
the raw mountains there. So this is what it looks like in the daytime. It looks exactly the same except light.
Do you let your guys know whenever they got bags and stuff, we're going to put them on the side of the TV?
Okay, we're told 0320.
Yeah.
Bags on. Chow.
Yeah. They were saying if any of them are just sitting there, they...
Morning, Master Sergeant.
Get the bunker.
Oh, you know what? How could I pass that up? That's good. Oh, that's where Matt got his picture taken. Somewhere like that. One of these things. There it is, the bomb bunker. Here.
Yep.
This is where we're told to go if any mortar rounds come in or there's a firefight of some sort. As you can see, it doesn't fit a whole lot of people. So we were told, if you don't haul butt and get down here, you're going to be going, trying to find one that doesn't have already 1,000 people clamoring to get inside. This is a camp right outside of Kandahar, Afghanistan. It is the 22nd of December. What's that? The range? Oh yeah, I'm heading there right now. As you can see, it's not exactly... Hey look, a dog. See the dog inside that car? Hey buddy. Very dusty. Very incredibly dusty. There he is. Everything is dust. And I'm not talking sand, I'm talking dust. This is the home of the 10th Mountain Division from Fort Drum, Watertown, New York. Very highly used military unit. Big time. You can see here the mountain ranges in the back. Looks just like New Mexico. It's so bizarre. Oh, this place. Bombed out. Afghanistan. Get a load of these mountains.
people say we don't need this war, but I say there's some things worth fighting for. What about our freedom and this piece of ground? We didn't get to keep them by backing down. They say we don't realize the mess we're getting in. Before you start your preaching, let me ask you this, my friend. Have you forgotten how it felt that day to see your homeland under fire and her people blown away? Have you forgotten when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside, going through a living hell. And you say we shouldn't worry about Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? They took all the footage off my TV, said it's too disturbing for you and me. It'll just breed anger, that's what the experts say. If it was up to me, I'd show it every day. Some say this country's just out looking for a fight. Well, after 9/11, man, I'd have to say that's right. Have you forgotten how it felt that day to see your homeland under fire and her people blown away? Have you forgotten when those towers fell? We had neighbors still inside, going through a living hell. And we vowed to get the ones behind Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? I've been there with the soldiers who've gone away to war. You can bet that they remember just what they're fighting for. Have you forgotten all the people killed? Yes, some went down like heroes in that Pennsylvania field. Have you forgotten about our Pentagon? All the loved ones that we lost and those left to carry on. Bin Laden. Have you forgotten? Have you forgotten? Have you forgotten?
A rookie, a wannabe, still wet behind the ears. A red line river just jamming his gears. There are those that are and those that ain't. The quickest get stickers, he was nothing but paint. Chartreuse paint. Big race, now a cut to the last 10 laps. Here comes Junior, sneaking up from the back of the pack with fire in his eyes, waving out the window as he passes him by. The tension mounts, now he's number two, all out of rubber and running on fumes. It's door to door, out of turn four. He sees those checkers and he hears that roar, and the crowd goes wild. Shining the honky-tonks. The roadside bar's a real humdinger, a blue-eyed singer with a red guitar around his neck, paying the dues about starving to death. But he told his mama every time he come back, one of these days I'm gonna buy you a big long Cadillac and get you out of this shack. Then he hit the road, fronting the band, six long hairs bobbing up and down in a Chevy van, all beat up. He did a lot of giving, but he never gave up. Then one night, he wrote a song, made a little record and started catching on. Now it's Coliseums, he's all the rage. The lights go down when he hits the stage, and the crowd goes wild.
Parker hit high and deep to right field. Jones to the track, to the wall. Goodbye.
Is good. Kick is in the air. It's got the distance.
Gets the full man. Three wide receivers, two to the left. He goes back to throw. Has time to the end.